Today we're visiting the largest game controller that was ever custom made for Steelbeats. It's located in the heartland of Denmark, in the Jutland Dragoons barracks in Holstebro. And watch me go green with envy. It all started with these old transportable cabins. Those were, after an extensive prototyping phase, made in a small batch by the Army Main Workshop. And the technology developed there was then later used in the big platoon level simulator hall that we're going to visit later.
My name is Johnny Jensen. I work at the Danish Army Combat Center, the Armored Branch, the research and development. Way back I was involved with still partly developing Steel Beast for personal use and also developing the trainer for adapting Steel Beast from the old software.
Then you started first to adapt control handles?
First, very simple control handles that opened for funding.
You stole them from the tanks?
We did, actually, yeah. Yeah, we borrowed them from the tanks, replaced a little part inside, and then that progress developed. We added more and more buttons, knobs, and ended up in the transportable container, or trainer cabins, as we call them.
And the reports from the users are positive?
They're very happy with it, because it's very user-friendly, and they get a good train out of it.
You're focusing on combined arms, high intensity platoon level. Yeah,
platoon level
combat
stuff, that's the general use, but we can use simulators in this room to connect to the platoon simulator and then do combined arms with overhead weapon stations with the CV90, 35, and ultimately infantry.
Overall, you would say that the choice for Steelbeast was giving you good value for the investment?
Absolutely. It started very simple way back, and now it's progressed and we have a lot of users in Denmark, and that's why we also add on licenses as we go, because everyone figures out, hey, this is clever, let's use it.
This year is then what? The instructor station
Where he can use.
If you're not using a networked exercise, but four individual tanks with four individual.
This is training
tank.
Just one tank or one gunner. Yeah. Instructor's computer down here and his own screen, and then a split of the gunner's screen and the commander's screen. We cannot see the driver's screen in case we're using the driver, but that's not necessary for the exercise. This is the old Leopard 1 compartment that was rebuilt or refurbished so that it's Leopard 2. In the old version we had a room for the loader and we had the breech and some of the barrel in here so that he would have to load the gun to some extent by pushing buttons. In the compartment there's room for the gunner and the commander. Thank you. engine off.
First we'll switch on the turret power and go to an emergency mode. Okay. And switch up to stabilized mode. And here we have the instruments. The commander's handle. Connector for intercom and radio with the channel selector. And well, here we have the ability to use the instruments just like we would do in real life as well.
I'm Captain Ulrik Sørensen. I'm the commander of the squadron that has been using the simulator today. I've been carrying out an koi attack with the tanks, three phases, in order to train our platoon leaders and commanders of the tanks, primarily also the gunners secondarily.
You started this morning at 8 o'clock approximately, and now it's well almost 2:30. So yeah, 6 hours straight in one single attack.
Yeah, that's correct. That's in order to keep it focused. We try to keep it together instead of having a lot of small breaks in there, especially when we do the training for the platoons. If we train the crews only, then we have a lot more stops in order to evaluate the their performance and find out their errors and what they did good.
Are you basically happy with the simulator setup, or is there anything left to be desired, further improvements that you would like to see?
I would say for a tactical point of view, I think it's as good as it is now. We have some small adjustments that I know that's been taken care of with a third part in order to be a civilian and so on. That's coming soon. But for the tactical point of view, it works as it sadly should.
In total, it was a good investment for the Danish taxpayer.
From my point of view, I believe it's good. It's a good way to train. It can never replace what the real training on the real tank, but it's a good supplement during training.
Oh crap, and we didn't record anything. Okay.